Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Come on and celebrate. It's what we sang. It's our opening entrance hymn. Truly, we celebrate today because we remember the feast of Our Lady of Lourdes. I'll say a few words after the Gospel. Pope St. John Paul II made February 11th as the World Day of the Sick. So I thought, let's take today's, it's an optional memorial, I thought let's take it as our Mass for today. And therefore we will have the readings of the feast today. Let's pause for a moment and ask the Lord. There are many areas in our lives which need healing. We may not have physical illness, some of us, but surely sometimes we may have emotional or spiritual or psychological illnesses that need healing. We ask the Lord for pardon and mercy. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You plead for us at the right hand of your Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant us, O merciful God, protection in our weakness, that we who keep the memorial of the Immaculate Mother of God may, with the help of her intercession, rise up from our iniquities. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from Prophet Isaiah. Rejoice, Jerusalem. Be glad for her, all you who love her. Rejoice, rejoice for her, all you who mourned her, that you may be suckled, filled from her consoling breast, that you may savor with delight her glorious breasts. For thus says the Lord, now towards her I send flowing peace like a river, and like a stream in spate, the glory of the nations. At her breast will her nurslings be carried and fondled in her lap. Like a son comforted by his mother will I comfort you, and by Jerusalem you will be comforted. At the sight your heart will rejoice, and your bones flourish like the grass. To his servants the Lord will reveal his hand. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let your response be, you are the highest honor of our race.
You are the highest honor of our race.
May you be blessed, my daughter, by God Most High, beyond all women on earth. And may the Lord God be blessed, the creator of heaven and earth. Your response?
You are the highest honor of our race.
The trust you have shown shall not pass from the memories of men, but shall ever remind them of the power of God. Your response?
You are the highest honor of our race.
Please stand for gospel acclamation. Alleluia, alleluia. Blessed are you, Virgin Mary, who believed that the promise made to you by the Lord would be fulfilled. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
3 days later, there was a wedding at Cana in Galilee, and the mother of Jesus was there. Jesus was also invited to the wedding with his disciples. When all the wine provided for the celebration had been served, and they had run out of wine, the mother of Jesus said to him, "They have no wine." Jesus replied, "Woman, what concern is that to you and me? My hour has not yet come." However, his mother said to the servants, "Do whatever he tells you." Nearby were 6 stone water jars set there for ritual washing as practiced by the Jews. Each jar could hold 20 or 30 gallons. Jesus said to the servants, "Fill the jars with water." And they filled them to the brim. Then Jesus said, "Now draw some out and take it to the steward." So they did. The steward tasted the water that had become wine without knowing from where it had come. For only the servants who had drawn the water knew. Immediately he called the bridegroom and said, "Everyone serves the best wine first. And when people have drunk enough, he serves that which is ordinary. But you have kept the best wine until the end." This miraculous sign was the first, and Jesus performed it at Cana in Galilee. In this way he showed his glory, and his disciples believed in him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Do you have any favorite devotion to Our Lady? Which one? Velankani or what? Our Lady of Fatima. Our Lady of Perpetual Circle. Yes. We used to say the novena on Wednesdays, right? Mary, Help of Christians. True. Our Lady of the Rosary. Another very popular devotion, especially in the month of May and month of October. Any other devotions? Nobody likes Our Lady of Lourdes? I was feeling bad for a moment. I'm kidding. Yes, you do. Is one more powerful than the other? All are the same. You're sure? There's one Our Lady. One Mother of God. Mata Dei. Yes. Good. On February 11th, 1858, a young 14-year-old girl, Bernadette Subiru, very poor family, hadn't studied much. She went out to collect firewood in southern France, Lourdes. And something told her that the wind was different. She looked up into the little hillock there, into the rocks, and little niche there, she saw this petite, little young lady dressed in white with a blue girdle around her waist. Something like the little statue as you go out of this chapel on this landing outside. She saw Mary holding a rosary in her arm. Mary led her to make the sign of the cross and to pray the rosary. When Bernadette went home, she told her sister, and her sister told her mother, and her mother gave her a good beating for telling lies. Mary had also invited her, "Keep coming back, I want to talk to you." So she did. Later, this news spread, and she had to say the same thing to her, to a priest. And the priest also scolded her. What visions are you getting? He told her these were lies. And finally, because of her perseverance, because of her persistence, the priest said, ask her her name. Ask that lady about her name. And she did ask that lady her name. On March 25th, the lady told her name. I am the Immaculate Conception. Now, Bernadette could not have said lies. The dogma of Immaculate Conception was promulgated just 4 years prior to that, 1854. Doesn't matter about that. But this poor girl could not have known that. She probably did not know very much. But a great fervor arose in the village. Many people believed her. Many people did not believe her. What to do? Our Lady appeared to her 18 times. Until July 16th of 1858. 18 times. In all this, as I said, many people were drawn closer to it. Now, during that time, this little girl, Bernadette, had to face a lot of humiliation from her family, from others, and a lot of inquiries were going on from church authorities and from medical authorities. They questioned her, they interviewed her. They thought this girl must be telling lies. But she stuck to her story. She did not waver. And the inquiries went on till 1862, when they said what she is saying must be true. From the time that Bernadette put her hands into that little sand and brought out the spring that was under there, spring that came out, until today, as far as I know, there have been 69 verified cures. My dear friends, the Catholic Church does not easily say something is a miracle. It goes through tremendous scrutiny and goes through the medical fraternity. The doctors, who may not be Christian, some of them may be atheists, and they carefully examine those who have got some miraculous cure. I'd like to end with these words of St. Thomas Aquinas, which you probably know. To anyone who has faith, no explanation is necessary. To one without faith, no explanation is possible. Through the intercession of Our Lady of Lourdes, let us ask the Lord to increase our faith.
The offertory hymn, number 125, on page 34. 125, page 34.
Comes a time we bring to you just a little bread and wine, my Lord. Just a little bread and wine. Morning time, a time for prayer. Just a little bread and wine, my Lord. Bread we take, we break and share. Just a little bread and wine.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that these our offerings may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Let us pray. As we honor the memory of the mother of your Son, we pray, O Lord, that the oblation of this sacrifice may by your grace make of us an eternal offering to you. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, to praise your mighty deeds in the exaltation of all the saints, and especially as we celebrate the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to proclaim your kindness as an echo, as we echo her thankful hymn of praise. For truly, even to earth's ends, you have done great things and extended your abundant mercy from age to age. When you looked on the lowliness of your handmaid, you gave us through her the author of our salvation, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with us, with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim,
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Philip Neri, our Bishop, the clergy, and all your faithful people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coheirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
You know, sometimes people get worried. They think that we are having not a trinity, but a quadrinity. We worship Mary, but that's not true of Catholics. That is sometimes an accusation against Catholics. Mary leads us to Jesus. When we pray the rosary, we meditate, we contemplate on the mysteries of Christ's life. And even in today's gospel, Mary tells the stewards and tells all of us, do whatever he tells you. And this is the prayer. She invites us to have union with Jesus and with the Father. Let's pray together. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of our Lord Jesus be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
This is Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are we who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
For communion, we shall take hymn number 289 on page 91. 289, page 91. Every tiny star that twinkles in the night sky, every drop of morning dew, every spark of fire blazing in the furnace, every captivating view, every rainbow in the sky, every pretty butterfly tells a fascinating news to those who dare to hold. Upon the seashore, every stalk of golden wheat, every silver stream that gushes down the mountain, every drop of honey sweet, every eagle flying high, every worm that wriggles by tells a fascinating news to those who dare to hold. Thank you.
Let us pray. Having been made partakers of eternal redemption, we pray, O Lord, that we who commemorate the mother of your Son may glory in the fullness of your grace and experience its continued increase for our salvation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Shall we have a prayer for healing?
Yes.
If you have anyone around you who is not well, and if you'd like to place your arm or hand on their head or shoulder, feel free to do so. And if you're praying for yourself, please pray, close your eyes. And if you're praying for some member at home, please bring them to mind. God of love, God of compassion, ever loving, ever caring, through the intercession of our Mother Mary, hear the prayers we offer for our sick brothers and sisters. Watch over your children gathered here this afternoon. Look after us in every danger and grant us your healing and peace. We ask this in the name of Jesus, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
May
Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I wish you all a very happy feast day.
Wish you the same, Father. Hymn number 333 on page 106. 333, page 106.